Greetings and welcome back to Nestora's YouTube channel, Dr. Hadzik here. In this series of videos, I will disclose my secrets that I use to build career and multiple winning teams. And a few years ago, I was asked to give a talk about building regional anesthesia service. And in preparation for that talk, I realized how much of that building process has to do with the team building, leadership, and using common sense approach to being successful. And throughout my life and career, I have read many books on success, I attended workshops, I watched videos, but what I realized is that much of that general public or business-oriented motivational material was too broad and not applicable to success in medicine. Instead, the feedback that I kept getting about my talks inspired me to distill my own experience in getting things done and being academically successful in this series of videos. And in this first video, I will lay out one of the most important ingredients in being successful, focus. And just before we dig into the principle of being focused, please do remember to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to turn the notifications on so that you never miss the next addition to this topic. So let's get started. Focus leads to success. You gotta know what you want. My students and younger people I mentor in my practice often ask me, how do I become known in anesthesiology? How do I become accomplished and successful? And in this video, I'm going to reveal the first of the 10 secrets I use to become known in the world of medicine. Let me just back up a bit by explaining why I may have inspired those questions by my students. The questions are undoubtedly inspired by the fact that I have published over 200 scientific articles, I hold a PhD, I have been professor at Columbia University in New York and honorary professor in prestigious universities in Europe, I publish the best-selling anesthesiologist books, and I run Nisora. So when they ask, how do I become successful, I ask them, what is it that attracts you? What is your passion? What kicks you out of the bed every morning and drives you throughout the day? The anesthesiology students typically startle and think for a moment, well, I like a little regional anesthesia, I like cardiac anesthesia, oh, and I quite like obstetric anesthesia, and I really love airway management. That answer is an instant diagnosis of the lack of focus and direction. Their focus is scattered. They don't know what they want. And because of that, they are not able to point and focus their efforts in the right direction. What they're really missing in the picture of my own success is the very focus. In my case, I focused on regional anesthesia and acute pain management. But they don't realize that this is the same as what in business is called branding. Everyone knows Coca-Cola, Mercedes, Apple, JBL. These companies did things right and did it for a long time. And their brands became synonymous for popular drinks, great cars, stylish computers, and a great sounding loudspeakers. So to become successful, you also need to focus and build your own brand around that focus until you set aside a few moments with a pen and a notepad to get a clear definition on what drives you and sharpen your focus, you will continue to get stuck in that whirlpool. This does not mean that you have to stick with one focus for the rest of your life. Indeed, as you gain confidence and experience in your path towards success on one focus, you can take on other projects. But only after you realize success in one main project and build your own brand recognition around that focus, you should take on other ones. In my own example, when I was starting out, I chose to work and improve upon techniques on nerve blocks because back in the 90s, there was no ultrasound and the techniques of regional anesthesia were very subjective. And after about a decade of successful work on this task where I built the brand recognition of my name in regional anesthesia, I have added additional projects such as developing e-learning systems of regional anesthesia so that the techniques that now have been very well established can be learned by virtually everyone with access to computer or the smartphone. The good news I tell to my students is that they are already successful. They were able to focus on completing medical school, which is one of the most difficult and longest educational journeys, often in solitude with countless hours of studying and dedication. But now, if you want to climb higher, the higher you climb, the thinner the air becomes. The more you have to focus on each step that you make. And to get to that summit, to the top, you really need to make one careful step at a time, every day, all the time, in one direction. And on that road, you need to pay attention to your steps and keep them pointed towards your goal at all times. You do not have the luxury to kill time on Facebook or YouTube, slouched on a couch during that climb. Success in branding yourself in medicine is no different. If you want to succeed in anything, you need to do it well, and you need to do it well for a long time. And eventually, your name sticks. Your name becomes a brand, a synonym for excellence and innovation in a certain section of medicine. Like my name became branded in regional anesthesia. What is important to understand that you don't really need to be super gifted or superhuman. We all made from the same material, same DNA. Our actions, dedication, and focus are what determine the outcome in the goals that we want to accomplish. What most people do is they meander. They start with something, then they turn their attention to something else, then they drift back to the idea they first thought of, so that they're back to where they started and they're not moving forward. A river never flows backwards. Today in particular, you need to super focus, as the new knowledge is typically not substantial, but only slightly incremental. So you really need to chip at a particular problematic like a stone with a chisel for a long time. And success will undoubtedly come. It is inevitable. The important message here is, if you are content to be a jack of all trades, you may never become the master of one. So you really have to focus on something very specific with consistency for a long time. In other words, do something well, do it for a long time, and success always comes. And you will become recognized, branded, and respected, and sought after for your unique skills. Feel free to post a comment or ask a question in the comment section, and do share some of your top tips for success yourself. Don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss the next video on this topic, which will be on recognizing your own strengths. Until next time.